The cell cycle consists of two major phases. The mitotic or M phase make up 10% of the cell cycle, which includes mitosis and cytokinesis. The rest of the cell cycle consists of interphase, which can be further divided into three subphases. During G1 phase, also called the first gap phase, the cell grows larger and synthesizes more proteins. During S phase, the cell replicates its DNA while also replicating centrosome, which is a type of microtubule organizing structure that helps separate DNA during M phase. During G2 phase or the second gap phase, the cell grows more, makes more proteins and organelles, and begins to reorganize its content in preparation for mitosis. Cell division consists of mitosis, the division of the nucleus, and cytokinesis, the division of the cytoplasm. Mitosis is conventionally divided into five phases: prophase, prometaphase, metaphase, anaphase, and telophase. During prophase, chromatin, which is the DNA content, become tightly coiled, condensing into discrete chromosomes. Each duplicated chromosome appears as two identical sister chromatids joined at their centromeres, and along their arms by proteins known as cohesins. The nucleoli disappear, and mitotic spindle, which composed of centrosomes and the microtubules that extend from them, begin to form. Recall that microtubule is a type of cytoskeleton that helps separate chromosomes during mitosis. Each centrosome is made of two centrioles. The radial arrays of shorter microtubules that extend from the centrosomes are known as asters. At the end of prophase, the centrosomes move away from each other, driven by the lengthening of microtubules between them. During prometaphase, the nuclear envelope fragments. Each of the two chromatids of each chromosome now has a kinetochore, a specialized protein structure at the centromere. Some microtubules attach to kinetochore, while other microtubules interact with those from the opposite pole of the spindle. During metaphase, the centrosomes are now at opposite poles of the cell. The centromeres of each chromosome align at the middle of the cell, forming the metaphase plate. Towards the end of metaphase and the beginning of anaphase, an enzyme known as separase cleaves cohesin proteins, separating the two identical sister chromatids from each other. Each chromatid becomes a full-fledged chromosome, which begin to move toward opposite ends of the cell as their kinetochore microtubules shorten. The cell also begins to elongate as the non-kinetochore microtubules lengthen. During telophase, two daughter nuclei form in the cell. Nucleoli reappear, chromosomes decondense, and microtubules depolymerize into tubulin subunits. Overall, mitosis divides one nucleus into two genetically identical nuclei. In animal cells, cytokinesis occurs through the formation of cleavage furrow, a shallow groove in the cell surface near the old metaphase plate. During cytokinesis, another type of cytoskeleton known as microfilaments form actin ring around cleavage furrow that tightens to contract. The cleavage furrow deepens until the parent cell is pinched into two completely separated cells. In plant cells, which contain cell walls, cytokinesis occurs through cell plate, in which Golgi apparatus builds a new cell wall between the two nuclei, forming two daughter cells. Prokaryotes reproduce by a type of cell division known as binary fission, and the two daughter chromosomes actively move apart. Certain protists exhibit types of cell division that seem intermediate between binary fission and mitosis. In both dinoflagellate and diatoms, the nuclear envelope remains intact during mitosis. In dinoflagellate, the microtubules pass through the nucleus, while in diatoms, the microtubules form within nucleus, similar to human cells. The frequency of cell division varies with the type of cell, which result from regulation at the molecular level. Growth factors are proteins released by certain cells that stimulate other cells to divide. For example, platelet-derived growth factor, abbreviated as PDGF, stimulate the division of human fibroblast cells in culture. Density-dependent inhibition occurs when the amount of nutrients and growth factors are insufficient, preventing crowded cells from dividing. Most animal cells also exhibit anchorage dependence, in which they must attach to a surface in order to divide. The sequential events of the cell cycle are directed by a distinct cell cycle control system, which consists of three main checkpoints. The G1 checkpoints checks for abundant nutrients, growth factors, appropriate cell size, and the absence of cell damage. If the cell does not receive the go-ahead signal, it will exit the cycle and switch into a non-dividing state known as the G0 phase. The G2 checkpoint is regulated by MPF, which stands for maturation promoting factor, or M phase promoting factor. MPF is made of two components: cyclin-dependent kinase and cyclin. MPF triggers a cell's passage past the G2 checkpoint into the M phase through phosphorylation of other proteins. Cyclin-dependent kinase is only active when cyclin binds, The cyclin concentration varies throughout the cell cycle. Cyclin is synthesized during the S phase, it peaks during M phase, and degrades during anaphase. Lastly, the M checkpoint occurs during metaphase, checking for chromosomal alignment at the metaphase plate.